kiss my leg and let her kiss my feet. I met this freak named Yolanda.
Shut this door, Rashawn.
Sean, shut the door, please.
That's why you turned your head.
We're up.
It's the Going Way Back Show with Money B.
Money B.
Classic hip hop, raw and uncut.
Raw and uncut.
And I'm sure there's a lot of you that don't recognize us because we are here at Morris Media Studios for the GoFundMe fundraiser. So please, 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 as we entertain you, please hit us up and make a donation, man, because this is the studio for the community.
Down
the poet is built hip hop.
That's right.
She built hip hop, goddammit.
This is
and
from the ground up.
And I know I say as always, but for those who are new to the Going Way Back Show, I am joined by my lovely co-host Ty Teezy.
Hey, hey, hey. I'm gonna make a donation right now.
Oh really?
Yeah, I'll make a donation.
Do you care to divulge the amount?
No.
But Ty Teezy, she's making a donation.
Making her donation right now.
And of course, later on in the show, I'll be
gifting away.
Raffling off? Whatever.
Raffling off, I guess, yeah.
For just donating. You're
for
donating.
For someone to make a donation.
Okay, there we go.
$150 or more. Signed Digital Underground t-shirts.
You can signed?
Signed.
Whoa.
Between Humpty Dance and the original Sex Packets t-shirt. Now, these are exclusive, hard to get t-shirts.
Yes, they are.
You really can normally only get them when I
don't even have this one yet.
You ain't got that one?
You forgot to introduce someone.
Well, we're not done, damn it.
My bad.
I was on the run.
Damn, we just started. Like that.
Can I get some volume, P?
That's what we do.
It's at the bottom.
Oh, no, on this.
Yeah. And like I was saying, I'm also joined by the Silver Fox that rocks, my man DJ Always.
What's happening, man? How you doing?
We go change his name to DJ Run.
Run for Run DMC?
Run.
Oh, nigga. Anyways.
I was doing a promo for the new BBD song, Run.
Yeah,
sorry.
For real. Mm. And
BBD. Yeah.
And of course, we got Mechanic Tariq in the building. What up, Pooter?
Say hi.
He ain't saying much. He ain't saying much. So what we like to do here at the Going Way Back Show, before we start every show, we like to just kind of give a rundown of what our week or weekend was like. And it was a pretty big weekend for Ty Teezy.
Yes, it was.
Yes, actually, I celebrated my birthday, a milestone.
Okay.
And if you follow me on some of the social media, you'll find out my age because advertised my age without my approval.
Oh,
but wow. It was really fun. Friday night, went to dinner with Mun and Little Pooter to a tapas restaurant. And then Saturday, my actual birthday, Mun threw me a surprise luau party. Always was there.
Everybody was there.
Fee was there. But it was a really nice turnout. So that's it. Sunday recuperated, Monday recuperated, and I'm finally feeling myself today. So it took me 2 whole days.
To recuperate.
To recuperate.
From Saturday.
From Saturday.
Wow.
Well, it started Friday.
Okay, so from Friday.
Yeah.
Thursday night.
Thursday night. Oh, okay. The truth.
Right.
What about you, Always?
You know, I was attending Ton's surprise birthday party, and I got there early and got recruited to set up shit. So I ended up setting up a lot of stuff for the party, and it was great. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you were surprised.
Oh, yeah, I was surprised.
Did he keep you out of the loop? Or
I didn't know what was going on, but I knew something was going on, but I didn't know exactly what was going on. And right. I was a little bit nervous. I thought it was going to be something corny.
You're nervous?
Yeah, because he does. I'm just going to keep it real. Y'all know me. He's not good at that stuff. Point blank. That's
it. Work on that, man.
I need to buy him a book.
Well, I thought the idea that you thought it was, I thought that was cool.
Oh, yeah,
like
it was cool.
Candlelight, you know, just dinner table set up with you. I mean, if Pooter would have been taken care of, I'm sure that would have been cool.
And that's hard to find somebody to
I mean, she ain't lying because, you know, like, men, we know what we want.
Very true.
We want this. Give me that.
Yes.
Women want you to know what they want.
Yes.
You're supposed to know what they want all the time. And then when you don't know,
read minds.
Then it's fucked up. But, you know, and the other thing that was hard about this whole thing is that we live way out. So we don't have any family or really a lot of people.
Nobody's close.
Like her one good friend helped me put it together. So there was nobody I could say, could you take her out and keep her gone?
Right.
She's not my one good friend. It's just a bunch of my friends. They live in L.A.
But you know what I mean? Like, not out where we live.
So wait, what did he have you doing? Why you? What did he have you send you on?
I just gave her money to go shopping and said, get out.
Best way to do it.
But. The money he gave me to go shopping was the money I was supposed to actually buy my gift. But I thought he already bought it, so I went and bought other things.
Well, it's but you know what? It technically, it's things that you wanted and needed. So.
But I really wanted the big thing.
Oh, of course.
So.
There's no winning. There's no winning.
Right? Yeah.
There's never any winning.
There's no winning.
I wasn't even trying to win. I'm just trying to.
You know what? You won by pulling off the surprise, man. Because she didn't know.
Right.
So
it worked out. It worked out.
I'll go with that one.
As for me, you know, all that stuff was happening, and obviously topped off last night. Season started. Niners kicked that ass.
Hey, yes.
And I'm happy for about 6 more days.
Till next Sunday.
Until they come back.
Wait, who y'all play next?
I don't even know yet. Yeah. I don't give a fuck. I'm just going to enjoy this. Beat L.A. That's what we did. So it was all good. But, you know, today... I'm sure everybody knows is a special day, and it's weird because it's almost the way people talk about it, it's almost like it's become an unofficial like holiday in our community.
Isn't that crazy?
And that is, you know, this is the 20th year anniversary of Tupac's death. Yeah, and it's
rest in power.
Yeah, it's crazy because you look up and 20 years has passed, right?
20.
Yeah, 20 years. Like, you know, and obviously, you know, another thing that was going on just recently is like, you know, just going off a little bit. But the whole thing with the rapper dude Lil Yachty and, you know, Tim saying that he doesn't know any Tupac or Biggie lyrics. Well, he's only 19. So, like, is this whole... I know they should, or at least like
but,
you would hope.
I mean, people have been celebrating Tupac every year for the last 20 years. So I know, Puda. I know it's terrible, isn't it?
We're gonna have to take your mic away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Use your words.
I'm trying to use headphones.
As we continue, man, I want to reiterate, please. Call in, make a donation, and call in. What's the number here?
323-293-3375. It's on that little piece of paper.
She is on it. Go time.
If you want to share a memory about Tupac, or even if you want to, you know, ask the show a question about Pac.
Or they can call in and say when they started really liking Pac, like at what phase.
Right. Yeah, I don't believe that, you know, I see 10-year-olds that know who Tupac is. Tupac's music is forever. You know what I mean?
And but that goes to tell me that maybe Yachty's parents weren't listening to Tupac.
He probably wasn't allowed.
Or some whatever it is. I mean, he's a youngster. I'm not gonna really go too hard on dude. But this is a point that I wanted to make. Somebody asked me, should he? If he doesn't, it's understandable. But my feeling is anything that you really, really want to be successful and take seriously, it seems like you should know the history of that. Meaning doctors have to know about past procedures. They have to study and learn it. Lawyers need to know cases that were, you know, that set precedent.
Know your history.
You have to know the history. Basketball player, you should know who Dr. J is.
Yes.
If you want to say if you really want to.
Yeah, you can have whatever opinions you want about today's game and past game, but you need to know who opened the doors for you to be there.
Yeah, I feel like you should. So, you know, even on the 20th anniversary of Pac's passing, he's still very, very relevant and in the news right now.
Isn't that crazy?
One thing that happened today, and was planned was they dropped the second trailer for the new Tupac movie, and Paul, this, if we could show that.
Yes, I had to do that.
Wanted to share that.
I'd love that too, because I actually the first drop I saw, the trailer I saw. I mean, I saw the other one, the first one they dropped, but this one, did they drop two?
Yeah, this
two
is
different
this,
ones,
this
right?
This is the second one. They did one.
No.
Oh, they
it's
did
the
two
second
today.
Time they dropped, but did they drop two on the second run?
No, they just dropped one.
Because I saw two different ones. I saw, unless it was a clip from that one, but the one I saw was the one, the clip from him in the elevator.
Okay.
And that was very intense. Like, I mean, they had like the talking to him with the gun in his face.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I was like, wow, that was intense. So
yeah, I mean,
is it all the same clip or is it two different clips?
No, it's a new clip.
And then the other one was like in a field and he was like looking.
Yeah,
and,
well, we're about to show everybody really quick if we got it or whenever we're ready.
I'm sorry, Mun, did you want the clip or the pictures?
The clip.
Okay, give me a second.
No problem.
Love the studio, POTUS. It's great in here. Looks great.
Yeah, it's icy.
Well, I saw it when none of this was in here.
Oh, okay.
So it was, you know.
All right, here we go.
It was a vision.
Too much with the air?
It's breezy.
Okay, hang on.
No, I'm not mad at it. Leave it. I was just saying.
I don't know what my so-called help is doing. Do I got help?
Easy.
No.
Get a 24-hour marathon and you lose help.
We all good.
I'm not only running the board, I'm co-hosting shows.
Yeah, I know. You're doing it all.
Running the parking lot, you know. Right? Niggas supposed to be up here. They in the kitchen getting turned up.
Well, rocking see.
It. When they should be in here helping us.
Turning it up.
We're going to get them. We're going to get them.
Okay, hold on one second, Mon. I'm trying to get you together.
Okay.
Y'all can talk about something.
Yeah, I know. I was about to get there.
I was taking a sip. I was like, you know, and then right after that, you know, we're going to get into the old school new news for those of you
coming up with Tyn Teezy.
Who've never seen it. Old school new news is Tyn Teezy segment where she gives us new news from classic artists.
Yes.
Tariq ain't having it today.
Hey, these mics are great because he's way over there.
Yeah, we're rocking today.
These mics are great.
Yeah.
But yeah. I had a great time at Tom's party.
Okay, I have the trailer if y'all want to get into that.
Yeah, let's check it out.
All right, give me. Here we go.
So, how many of y'all heard what the vice president said about it? Kill innocent black folk every day. Real shit would have to do. Well, I'm doing people with that. You feel? This shit would have to do my whole life. But you know what I gotta say to these motherfuckers? You wanna know what I gotta say to these motherfuckers?
Unlike you, my constituents ain't Booker T. Washington motherfuckers. They're hustlers, street soldiers, and mothers trying to get off welfare.
Like all black leaders, you have a bullseye on your back.
I ain't no black leader.
They are gonna come after you with everything you know. They are gonna give you the tools that you need to destroy yourself.
You on pop 24/7. It's on.
Well, I'll be ready. That's what I do.
What the fuck is happening?
What happened to me? I got shot from behind times. If a nigga coming at me, get him, he gon' get killed.
Loyalty is everything.
The picture that you paint with your pen, that's your truth. But the picture the media paints, that's theirs.
The nigga gotta pay. He gotta pay for that shit.
Don't you throw your life away like I did. The whole fucking world will know Tupac.
I can't wait.
Right?
I cannot wait.
POTUS, had you seen that already?
I had not seen that trailer, but it looks hella dramatic. Was right? His life that dramatic?
Man, you think?
So you guys should donate just for seeing the trailer, y'all.
It's all here first,
y'all. Was that exclusive?
It was a premiere.
All right. You know yeah, I mean? Donate. GoFundMe.com/Morris Media Studios. We'll be giving you guys a tally in just a moment.
Yeah, and
something, Paul.
And we're also in the number once again, POTUS.
323-293-3375, Tanya.
Oh, yeah. Time teasy. Now, what were your thoughts
on? I usually say the number fee. ODP. I got it. Thank you.
I shall turn my mic off now.
I would have gave you the whip, but I need to be up.
We love that you're a part of the show, but that's my job.
So what are your thoughts on the trailer?
I wasn't watching the trailer, but if it's any of the scenes from the movie, I will say that I liked the movie a lot. But it's going to be interesting how his fans take the movie, because there were some things in the movie that I would have never thought Tupac was. Like, I didn't realize he was so sensitive and in tune with the laws and read a lot of poetry. So it was a very insightful movie.
Interesting. All right.
Well, you know what?
Yeah, a lot of people,
But he actually did read a lot. You know, and I tell people, you know, because kids come up and like, you know, I'm just like Pac, or you know, I'm gonna be like Pac, and I always say, like, if you really want to be like Pac, read a book.
Cause Pac pretty much
read a lot.
Yeah.
You know, there's such a thing as, you know, obviously they see the wild or the crazy side, but that's like one dimension. You know, and he wasn't a two-dimensional character. You know what I mean? He was a handful.
Looks like we have a call. Oh. Caller, what's your name and where are you calling from?
This is Nikki Pam from The Rollout Show.
Hi, Nikki Pam. How are you?
I just saw the trailer. It looks amazing. Mm.
Are you ready to see the movie?
Heck yeah. Right. I'm all on it.
Okay, we'll try to get you some premiere tickets.
Now,
I love you, Time TV. And I just wanted to say I had a ball at your house the other night. Even though we were hella late, but it was still fun.
I was more concerned about you guys. I was like, I'm sorry, this is not Hollywood.
Girl, please. What nobody think about Hollywood? I'm mad I missed you always. I haven't seen you forever.
I know. Hadn't it been forever?
A long time.
Ever.
Nikki Pam jumped in the pool.
Oh, and
he was on.
And
what?
I missed that?
Yes.
Shut up with the hair?
Yes.
Yep. You know that would go happen.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you guys are doing a fabulous job, and I'm enjoying the show. I just wanted to call in and say hey. And hey, Tariq, how you doing?
Tariq!
Working my nerves.
He can't hear me.
No,
he's
playing the game.
He don't have his headphones on.
He's acting Hollywood today.
He's playing the game.
He is.
Yes.
Also, Pam, thank you for my bracelet. I'm wearing it today.
Oh, that's dope.
Oh, you have it on?
Yes, if you can see.
Oh. Cool.
It matches the studio.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, you got a point. I'll give you some more time.
All right. Thank you.
You guys have a great show. I'm watching, though.
All right. Thanks for tuning in.
Bye.
Bye.
All right. So yeah, man, even me, and even though I've seen the screener, that trailer made me want to see it again.
Right.
And I didn't know.
But that's what gets people out to the movies is trailers. So if the trailer is dope,
right. It's
going to entice you to get there. So, you know, it did its job.
And a little bit later in the movie, a little bit later in the show, I'm sorry. I got some pics that I took during the filming of the movie. Oh, for those of you who don't know, I'm actually was a part of the movie. You know? I was on set.
He was there. He actually saw the guy that played Tupac.
Yeah.
We have a question out of the chat room. They want to know when the movie's coming out.
Now that is the billion dollar question. We don't know. And it's crazy because I went and saw one of the latest screeners not too long ago. Ooh, excuse me.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, we were all trying to get that date.
That date.
And to be totally honest with you, you know, don't quote me, but I don't know that they have the date yet.
I thought they were going to try to release it like around this time, but I mean, to throw out a trailer on this day is
not as perfect.
And they should have released it today.
I was thinking the same.
If it was possible, you know, movie shit is.
Yeah, well, I mean, usually movies get released on Wednesdays and. Is it Wednesdays?
I don't know.
I think movies are Wednesdays and music is Tuesdays.
Is my mic still on?
I know, it's like it's in and out.
Yeah, it's going, okay, okay, there we go.
It's cool, we're good.
Yeah, but, you know.
That's why we need you guys to donate, so we won't have shortages in the mics.
Talk about time.
Please donate.
Now, we, so, no, I heard that the movie was coming out in November, and then I'm hearing that it may come out next year. It, to me, it doesn't matter. Whenever it comes out, people are going to go see it, and, you know, no.
No, yeah, I know. Like, I mean, like, I'd rather sooner than later, like, but, you know.
I mean, I wish it would come out tomorrow.
Exactly.
But, you know, as successful as, say, the NWA movie, which was a great movie, Straight Outta Compton.
Yes, it was.
Loved it to death.
Yeah.
This movie is going to shatter, or whatever you want to say, it's gonna surpass it, you know.
I even liked the Notorious movie. I did.
I did not.
You didn't?
Which one?
You didn't?
Notorious. That was what?
Notorious? You didn't like it?
No.
I didn't see it.
Call us up if you like that movie.
323.
Well, I mean, who's going to do it?
Who,
I'm sorry.
9333. What's that, 75?
Once again.
Yeah, it was a bad movie.
We have a call. Caller, what's your name and where you calling from?
Sorry, yo, what's up, y'all? It's Dwight Kirkpatrick and Kelvin.
Hey, Dwight. Hateful Eight.
How you doing? Yo, always. What's up, Playboy?
What's up, man? How you feeling?
I mean, I'm feeling good, man. Got off the job site and I'm looking to log in. I see you got Mun on there, TV, even got a little Tariq. I'm like, yo, man, I gotta call this because I be fucking with y'all's show on the YouTube. So, yeah, man. Y'all gonna move over to the studio or what?
Hey.
One day.
Hey, we don't know what's going to happen.
Man, we get enough donations.
No, I got that covered, man. I already hollered at OT about that, so I'm going to take care of that on mine.
Okay.
Yeah, she got to change that decor. It doesn't really match my, you know,
oh,
my
yeah,
Steve's.
Got to get some picks back here.
Tizzy going in today.
Yo, right? She is.
Yo, man, I got a question.
Okay, go ahead,
now,
shoot.
You were talking earlier about, asking folks to pretty much, relay some kind of a Pac memory or whatnot, you know, just to, pay homage to the great MC that he was.
Sure.
Now, I was thinking about what happened, I think it was the BET Awards, when they had old boy fuck up the whole Biggie situation to the point he had to give a public apology. Now, I'm thinking, because all these new, no-name or upcoming rappers or whatever coming up, they ain't paying homage to the greats the right way. So, like, what kind of advice do you give them cats so they can actually go out and pay attention so they can actually strive to be just as great? You know what I'm saying?
Well, you know, I actually just mentioned that, is that I just feel like you should want to know what came before you. You know, now, like I always say, your opinion is your opinion, but mm-hmm. at least know enough to have an opinion.
Right.
You know, and I made a statement earlier, is like, you know, hip-hop, you know, you always want to be original and do things. Like, how do you know that it hasn't been done before?
If you haven't looked.
If you don't know what happened before.
Exactly.
You know, you could be the clown that's doing something all over again, and they'd be like, oh, dude, did that 10 years ago.
People fail to realize that the skinny jean thing was, like in the 80s. They kind of started out like that.
Yeah, and they should have left it in the 80s.
It wasn't skinny jeans. It was like skinny leather pants and shit. You know what I'm saying? That's what it was.
Well, I'll tell you what. I had some, I don't know if y'all remember the 50, was it 505s?
Yes.
I had some, and I looked at the picture, and they might have been a little snug. but you know what, though? The legs didn't get all thin at the end.
But we had creases, too.
Yeah, we did.
But what about the OJs? They used to wear those skinny suits, pants.
At least they breathed a little bit though.
But they actually clarified that. They, you know, they say back then who they were competing with, you know, they were competing with stage performances and shows.
Right.
So that's where that came from, you know, being all flamboyant and wild out like that until they figured out, hey, do our own.
Styles of dress come and go, and I think people will always dress in where they were the most comfortable. Like, you know, like if you was popping, you know, like say most of us, our heyday is in our 20s, you know what I mean? 20s, early 30s. That's when we was rocking. So if you're 20 something and the way you're dressing now, you're probably going to always like that style of dress.
Right.
Moving forward.
Yeah.
You know, like I'm comfortable, like, you know, like not super baggy, but just, yeah, you know, comfortable jeans and whatnot.
These cats are comfortable wearing skinny jeans and shit, you know.
Oh, yeah, they're not comfortable.
Yeah.
It's not comfortable.
But no, I get what you're saying.
How you know you tried today's?
I have not.
Oh, okay.
I'm sorry.
Oh, no, I was saying, I get what you're saying, but I brought that up because, like you said before, I had this conversation with my son. He was up here listening to some of the bullshit that's on the radio.
I'm sorry.
And then he hit me with some, yeah, thanks always. Yeah, I'm sorry, too. But no, man, and then he hit me with something like, well, you know, it ain't like it was back in your old day. And, you know, when the kids hit you with that, they kind of hurt a little bit. But I was like, yo, man, you need to listen to this. So then, you know, I pulled up some EPMD. I was trying to have him listen to me. He was like, I don't get it, you know. But he want to listen to some motherfucker who, you know, not even speaking English. I don't get that.
The mumble rap.
Yeah, you know?
Yeah, trust me. I've been hit with the, who is Rakim and what is that?
Just for somebody to say that about Rakim, it's like, come on, man.
But then they listen to Lil Yachty. Like he rocking.
Who is that?
But all right, y'all. I'm gonna get out, man. But like I said, man, I'm gonna keep peeping the show on YouTube, man. What you guys should do, man. I don't know. Find TV, you know. Let folks know on the page, you know, when you got a new episode on, because like I kind of binge watch your episodes on YouTube.
On what page?
No, on the group page.
Oh, but, I didn't want to like co-mingle because I didn't get approval from. POTUS, if it's okay to post our show on that page.
Of course you can.
Okay, thank you. So now I'll start posting on the Rollout group.
Yeah, man. Okay, thank you. Good show, man. I like it, but I'm going to keep peeping y'all. OG, I'm going to drop that donation too, so don't worry about that.
And you make sure you share our episodes.
Oh, I do?
Okay, great. Thank you.
All right, fam.
Thanks, bye. Appreciate it, man.
Appreciate your support.
Word up. Once again, the number, Tontezy?
323-293-3375. And make sure you donate to GoFundMe.com/Morris Media Studios with an S.
Now, we're going to continue to celebrate and talk about Tupac here on the 20th year anniversary of his death. But before we go any further, I'd like to go into one of my favorite segments, and that would be the old school new news with Tontezy. And before we go, POTUS, we ready with those? Okay, let's do it.
Thanks, man.
Do it, Tezy.
All right.
Do it. Do it. Shout out to the Hateful Eight.
And just let me reiterate that this.
Well, let me just say this, Hateful Eight. Normally, Tontezy, she come in and she do all her. She was extra. She like, oh shit, this is my audience.
My people gonna see me.
She was combing her hair this way and then coming that way.
Oh, look, we have a call.
Oh.
Caller, what's your name? Where you calling from?
Hey, how y'all doing? This is G Lou. I'm calling from Atlanta right now, but I'm from LA. But I had a question for Money D or about the Tupac situation in the movie. I'm real anxious myself to see the movie. I've seen the trailers, and of course, a big Pac fan, you know, at the beginning, grow up with him, everything. I had a question about the movie since you guys seen it already. Do you think, in your opinion, will we get like the, not the NWA experience where it was a great movie, you all know, but a lot of people know, you know, it's a lot of controversy over the movie, what was real, what was left out, you know, how they portrayed these different things. So will we get the official, what I'm trying to say, story about Pac? I know it's still Hollywood movies, but will we get a real depiction and a better story somewhat than the NWA movie did for the people
We got it.
I mean, I hear what you're saying, but in my personal opinion, and I've actually, you know, I was around NWA, like, let me just say, Adrian Gregory, who was our manager, he got his start working for Jerry Heller, and he was Ruthless Records' road manager. He was NWA's road manager, and JJ Fad, and all of those guys. So when we first came in the game, we were around NWA, and some of the things that I knew didn't exactly happen that way, but that didn't not make it a great movie.
Right.
No, that's what I'm saying. I enjoyed the movie. I'm not saying that at all. I enjoyed the movie.
Yeah, like when Ice Cube and them. I'm sorry.
People felt maybe it was Ice Cube and Trey's story opposed to how they portrayed Easy. A couple little things. Not saying it's still a great movie. I love it.
Well, in Straight Outta Compton, I heard that a lot.
Yeah, I can see that.
And you know, the one thing about that movie, it was controlled mainly by Ice Cube and Dr. Dre.
Okay.
So, and obviously, there's no matter what we say, if I make a movie or if you make a movie, there's always going to be an agenda. Meaning your agenda, if it's your movie, your agenda is going to take, what do you call it? You know, precedent or whatever.
Yeah.
It's all about that, regardless. Right.
Or are you going to speak up on those parts when
I think that it was a lot of different people's input that allowed it to be portrayed the way that it was. Once again, I enjoyed that movie. I thought it was a great movie.
It was
excellent. From day one, money. You were Pac from day one. We all understand like I said, I'm a Pac fan day one.
Well, this
I
is the thing.
Wanted that question, you know, to see, and then I seen the trailer and I seen a few things. Far as like you know that like the lady said, people may not know, but even in the trailer, I seen some kind of outlands like shootouts and you know him look like he being stabbed in prison, which a lot of people didn't know. I didn't know that, so you know that's why I was asking those questions.
Without giving it up, I'm gonna say you should definitely go see this movie because the trailer is there to excite you. But one thing that I always tell people about Tupac. Is like you say, like you know, I was there from day one. Well, I wasn't there from day one. I was there, in that time. So even us, like say the people that were in it in the time that he was with Digital Underground, we weren't. I wasn't around Death Row at all. You know, Death Row wasn't around Digital Underground.
Right.
Death Row wasn't around Ray Love and Marin City. Right. Jada wasn't with Death Row. We weren't in Baltimore when he was going to school there. So there's nobody that took the entire journey with Tupac. So even all of us that were a part of his life, we're interested in seeing the movie as well because we want to know what happened in those other parts of his life. Because, you know, when I met Pac, he used to always talk about his mom. At the time, his mom was on drugs and we used to have serious conversations, but he never spoke. He never spoke down or bad about her. He just spoke, but he was always honest, and he was just sad. It's like his best friend is not with him.
Right.
So when I met her, there was like almost like an instant bond because I knew so much, and my dad was in the Black Panther Party. She was, So I grew up, and even me growing up the way I grew up, when he would talk about things, I got it more than most people. But when I saw the movie, I actually got to see the interaction before I met him,
right?
Which I only heard, but now I'm watching it, so I got a little emotional just seeing that part of the movie, you know, and then the other things that happened in his life. I'm like, word, and I know that people from other stages in his life felt the same way seeing the other parts that they heard about.
Yeah.
So you know, everybody's interested, and I will say that, you know. When you make a movie, you have to make a movie. So regardless, it has to be interesting. And the other thing that you may find, or at least I'd like to share, and hopefully this will help with your opinion on everything once you do see it, is that this movie is not anyone's story about Tupac. Most of it is interviews. The story is taken from his interviews. And it's taken from interviews of people that were in his life. So not saying like, well, what is... So it's not like, nah, you got to play me like this. Mm-hmm. It was kind of like he just took... Mm-hmm. It's almost like it's a movie that's being told from his perspective.
Right.
You know, because nobody... And there's a lot of people right now that are mad because they felt like they didn't get... They're not in the movie or they didn't get... They're not in the movie more. You know, everybody feels like they're most important. But at the end of the day, Tupac is the most important. Definitely. It's about him. So it's not, you know, I wish there's things that in the movie I was like, I should have been there or they should have did more but it's not my story.
It is what
I
it is.
I was talking to Big Psych also. He said he didn't have a part in it. I don't know. I feel he should probably be portrayed somewhere in there, but he said they didn't really consult him.
Right. And it's, you know, all of one thing about me is I feel like I'm cool with mostly everybody that, you know, from back then. And right. I will tell you that a lot of people chose not to include themselves when they could have and had a little more input. You know, not saying it's any one person, but I've had conversations. But then also being on the set, having conversations where it's like they didn't say anything.
Right.
You know, and everybody, you know, everybody, like, nobody's going to, you know, you can't please 100% of the people. You never will.
Right. So
you can only do the best. And I seen the hard work that was put in by the people that were involved. And I was involved slightly. And I saw it. And obviously, sometimes when you're close to something, you have to stand back and ask somebody else, like, was this good like I thought it was?
Objective,
or am I just
tripping?
Because maybe I'm not objective. Because he was my friend and I want it to be great.
Right.
But it's good. I think
I appreciate that people like who were involved, Benny Boone, the director, you know, people that come from hip hop. So, and probably, you know, I don't know if he knew Pac, but I know he came up on his music. And he's a direct video, you know, come from hip hop. So I know the story can come across a little better. You know what I mean? Like you said, in previous stuff like the Biggie movie and all that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? So.
And one thing I'll add even about Benny Boone is that Benny was great for the movie because he actually, like, you know, they went through, you know, I think Benny was like the fourth director before they settled on a director.
Damn.
And it was like, you know, originally it was these white dudes that was going to write it. And then John Singleton. And then it was another cats. Well, at the end of the day, I think Benny was the right person to do it because Benny actually came up in hip hop in that era.
Right,
you know, he's roughly my age.
Right.
And so he remembers how we dressed and how 30. We talked.
Right.
And the lingo. And so when, you know, you see people doing it, it's like, hey, we didn't dance like that.
Right.
Benny's like, right. And he knows it. So he knows when it's authentic, when it's not, because he lived that era.
Right.
As opposed to say
just some random director. Yeah.
Just somebody who wasn't as hip hop.
Yeah.
Or who wasn't as in tune with what it was.
Has history, but wasn't from hip hop.
Exactly.
You know, kind of how Hype Williams did with Belly. That was a great look, you know, because he comes from hip hop. You know, it was a better look, you know, for even close to the story. So
exactly.
I know Benny's going to do a good job. You know, like I said, I just had a question on that because I just wanted your opinion on that. I'm like you said, I'm a Fox fan. I'm going to see the first day out.
Believe it.
You know what I'm saying? Definitely. You know what I'm saying? I just wanted to voice my opinion on that because I'm sure people are wondering because that was the thing with the NWA. Everybody anticipated it, and it was still a great movie.
Yeah, and I appreciate it. And then there's always going to be, there's some people who just will never be satisfied or pleased or accept anything unless Tupac rose from the dead and played himself.
Well, let's wait for him to do that, and then he can make an opinion on his own movie. Moving on.
Nope. Yep.
All right, G-Lou, man.
All right, man. Much love, man, to y'all.
Thanks
man.
For the call. Great we appreciate job. Your support.
Appreciate the call.
I check you guys' show out also, you know, randomly, you know, on your channel also.
Are you a subscriber?
Yes, I am.
Oh,
yes,
good.
I am.
Thank
and
you.
And have you made a donation?
I've seen pretty much 80% of your show. You know, I keep up with it.
Oh, man, thank you so much.
We appreciate it.
Have you made a donation yet?
No,
Tomorrow's
I
Media Studios?
I'm about to look into that now.
Please do. Appreciate the call.
Anything
okay,
will
love.
Help
y'all
out.
Anything. Okay.
Thanks.
All right, let's go get back to this special edition of the Old School New News.
I think you should redo the intro. Goodness.
Yeah.
Let's go, Tom Teezy.
No,
this is the Old School New News with Tom Teezy.
Thanks, man. Up first, we got Nelly. Looks like he owes the IRS $2 million in back taxes.
Oh, shit.
That includes...
Tip drill.
That includes penalties and interest. So if he doesn't come up with a settlement with the feds, they can seize his property, his assets, and his bank accounts.
No.
So right now, he is working with his accountants to reach a settlement.
I wonder how that happens.
Do you think it's the accountant's responsibility?
I really think it's the accountant's. But I think it's more of his responsibility not being on his accountant.
Yeah, right.
What's going on?
And it seems like, to me, it seems like Nelly's pretty intelligent.
But you know what? Just as long as their money is okay and their credit card is going through, they're probably not even thinking about their taxes because they're trusting their money into their accountants to take care of that for them.
I understand that, but he has a show. He had a show. So and the show was based on him taking care of a lot of, you know, so I would think he would be more in tune with that.
Be on top of it.
He'd be on top of it because his show was about taking care of kids that aren't even his, you know.
What show are you talking about?
Nellyville.
Nellyville.
Oh, okay. I never heard of it.
You watched it. It was on BET or something.
No,
yeah,
with
did.
His little kids, his daughter, and well, care I, of his people.
I will say this: if I hear like Lauryn Hill and everybody else is getting in trouble, I'll be on top of my accounts. And just
right.
that alone, we're like, are y'all on this shit? Because I don't want nobody coming after my
exactly.
stuff, and I'm not doing nobody's
exactly.
time. So,
I mean, I owe taxes some of them years.
Well, you
not millions.
Get on them.
It might accumulate to that if you don't get on top of it.
Huh. Interest ain't no joke.
Yeah, I know about it too. I owed. I reached a settlement, and I paid, and I'm done with it. And I will never mess with them again. All right, moving on. So last week, Jerry Heller passed away. He passed away in a car crash, which was a result of a heart attack.
Oh shit!
He died.
Wow! I didn't even know that.
He died at the age of 75. But although he's gone, his lawyers are still going to pursue the lawsuit, the defamation lawsuit against the portrayal in the biopic Straight Outta Compton. He's suing the group, of course, NWA, the movie producers, and Eazy-E's estate. He's asking for a total of $110 million. Well,
wow.
Not him anymore.
Not right.
His lawyers.
His representatives.
Right. Does he have any kids? Because I'm thinking if they do win, I doubt that they will win that much. Who gets the money? Does he have an estate? Does he have any kids? Like, who did...
She give it to Adrian.
Right?
He raised that nigga.
Well, he's saying that in the movie, they... portrayed him as withholding $75,000 of Ice Cube's money. The unfavorable contract between Ice Cube and Dr. Dre, and the firing of Eazy-E firing him as his manager. He said none of that was true. He even went on to say that the scene in the movie of them having lobster brunches, mm-hmm. that wasn't even true. But, you know, things are always loosely based on the truth. He's also saying that they took things out of his own book and put it into the movie.
Mm-hmm.
And so that's why he's seeking $110 million. I mean, I keep saying him, but his lawyer. So good luck with that. Oh, and when Ice Cube was asked how he felt about his passing, he said, quote, "I ain't gonna pop no champagne, but I ain't gonna shed no tear either," end quote.
Wow.
You know, loss of a life is bad all around. But
it's bad.
If, you know, personal attachment is what, you know, they were looking for. They were like, you know, what are you going
to
say?
Oh, and then his lawyers even went on to say that this lawsuit might have caused him to have this heart attack because he was so stressed.
Of course.
Maybe if he stopped eating bad food. Well,
lobster.
By the hotel pool.
Rest in peace, Mr. Heller.
Wow. Oh, you know what? You know what? Now, POTUS, I want to ask you a question while I'm here. Speaking of the movies and things, so there is one part of the movie. I know you and Eazy were tight like that, but the one part of the movie that tripped me out is when, you know, they had him like he was going back to sell weed or something. He had money. That was around the time when Bone Thugs was coming out. What?
Yeah, well, Shari was just here earlier, and she was talking about some of the things that were not true necessarily in the movie, and that was one of them. And
I mean, that was almost, it seemed like that
and
was
I
obvious.
Even brought up that same point that you brought up that at that time, and she said that Bone went like seven times platinum.
Yeah.
So
right. He should have had cash.
But I will say this, Easy did always have weed. He used to have like garbage bags.
Yeah, but he wasn't going back to selling it.
I would say, I don't know what he was doing with it, but I remember one year we had the birthday party at our house for Sheena's birthday. Were you there that night, Mon?
I wasn't there. But I remember.
I miss that always. But he came to our party and shit. He bought Sheena ounce for her birthday and just the whole party was lit. Just but
literally.
And I remember because Easy used to do a radio show at 92.3 The Beat back in the day.
And with Hutch, right? You and Hutch.
It was him and Julio G.
Okay. Julio G.
Oh yeah.
And I remember one time looking in a refrigerator at the station. And back in a little crisper drawer, big old bag full of crispy,
and it was in there. But I mean, they made it the way they portrayed it, like he was going.
I don't think Easy was ever short of money. I don't think that.
What is crispy?
That means
crispy green.
Yeah, some greenery.
But they kind of assumed that they made it seem like that in the movie.
Like he was Adam dough, like he had to go back and sell weed,
or he was doing something else
because he was also moving out of his house too. I think at that point, he was getting a smaller house.
That was the one thing in the movie I was like,
I don't know about that.
But whatever. Go ahead, Todd Season.
Okay, so like we've been talking about all during the show, today marks the 20th anniversary of Tupac's death. And with that, there is a memorabilia company by the name of Moments in Time who is trying to sell handwritten lyrics from the song Catching Feelings. Fillings. And the estate is actually trying to block them from selling those lyrics. And if they are sold, they're asking for $38,000. So, and even from the grave, Afenia is blocking everybody because she, and you can speak on this too, man.
Yeah. I'm listening.
She really set everything up and did everything right on her son's behalf to make sure that anyone wasn't getting money off of his memory.
And
you can speak from experience too if you want.
Yeah, she left the estate. Tom Wally controls the estate. Peter Paterno is the main attorney for the estate. And so they are the ones, they're like the gatekeepers. But what it is, it's become harder for people who, like, you know, I forget who I was talking to yesterday, and they were just saying, like, man, you know, when Afeni was alive, it would have been easy to get this cleared.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you could have a conversation with her, and she could make that call and say, hey, clear it. Now, you know, you can't just
do
that.
It's a process.
Like, it's not, it's not, you know, the people that knew Afeni and that could... would normally be able to get things done.
Mm-hmm.
You can't get them done so easily now.
Right.
Because now it's strictly by the book. Mm-hmm. Whereas if any, if she knew you, she'd go, just go ahead and do it.
Yeah, you know, she can make the call.
Right.
Now there's nobody to make that call.
There's nobody to make the call.
Unless you have a personal relationship with those people in the office.
Yeah, like I know Tom Wally and I know Peter Paterno. you know, Peter Paterno was actually the president of Hollywood Records when I was signed. When I was signed to Hollywood Basic. So I know Peter pretty well. And Tom Wally, he was trying to sign Raw Fusion and Tupac together when Atron first did that deal. It was supposed to be a package deal. So I know Tom from back then. And I can call them. But even then, they like, okay, we got to.
It's a process.
And interesting enough, I had a phone conversation with Busta Rhymes the other day. And he has this. Yeah, do it again.
I got to do it.
Do it again. So he played me the song that he has with a Pac verse on it, right? And I was like, I never heard this. So I was like, dog, where you get this from? So he called me. He was like, yo, you know, him and Pac, they went in the studio. I guess Pac wanted him to do something, and they went in the studio together. And he said Pac sent him files to like 5 or 6 songs that he wanted.
I believe
Bust to get on.
Yeah.
And he said that he's been holding on to these verses for like 20 years. It's crazy because when you hear.
And never bothered to. Wow.
I mean, he just had.
That's hard.
He just had them. And so, but it's crazy when you listen to it because it had to be. he had to do it like in, let's say, 95 or 94. And they sound, it sounds relevant.
He's
It's rocking, you know what I mean? But because Tupac has always stayed relevant, his music has, because it's him, his flow and his cane, everything just sounds now anyway.
Yeah.
Because it's Tupac.
Yep.
It just sounds like the music that we hear him now. But I even told Busta, like, I heard a whole album that Tupac did with MC Bree. And I've never heard any of that come out. And I know Tupac did an album with Madge from the Live Squad.
And that never came out either?
I haven't heard it. Wow. So, I mean, you know, I always say, like, there's even more than the Interscope Death Row catalog, Tupac has a lot of music out there.
Right.
And I know people are just trying to figure out how they can, what they can do with it, because it does get locked up. I'm getting that breathing sigh because Tyan Teezy wants her segment back.
She's not done.
Well, it's over, but I just wanted to do my outro.
Okay, well, bust it.
And check your phone.
Okay, do it.
And, oh, yeah, I have a funny story. Not a funny story, but I wanted to share something with the viewers. So I played the wingman 20 years ago. My friend actually introduced Mun and I on the hopes of meeting Tupac.
Wow.
And a month later, September 13th, he passed away. So she never got to meet Tupac, but we've been together ever since then. And I wasn't checking for him like that, but we just hit it off like that.
Wow.
Yeah, she wanted to meet Pac, so she was like, my friend wants to meet you.
And I didn't even know who he was.
And then I was like, you wanted to meet me? She was like, shit, you wanted to meet me?
No.
Because we met in Oakland. It was Chocolate Thursday. It was after a strip club.
At Jeffrey's.
At Jeffrey's? Oh, was shit.
It was the original Jeffrey's.
Oh, okay. Because I thought called something different.
The one upstairs, right?
No. That was the original Jeffrey's. Then it moved to Thursday.
Okay. Yeah, I went to the one upstairs.
It was the next Jeffrey's.
So I'm dancing on the dance floor with somebody else, and she come up to me and she was like, I just hooked you up with Money B. And I was like, who? And she said, Money B. I was like, who is that? He gonna hook me up with Tupac. Girl, let's just go. Come on. And I knew she loved Tupac. I was like, okay, whatever. So that's how we met. And
Wow.
Been in love ever since. Thanks to
I knocked the boots that night.
Lies.
No, I'm just playing.
I believe it.
Yeah, get him back.
He wish.
It was the next night.
So my homegirl, who's we're really close, we call each other sisters. So we're still good friends, and
that's great.
Her hooking us up and have the little fun. So.
Shout out.
The results. Wow. I am not mad.
And that's this week's Old School New News on the Going Way Back Show with my man Money B. And again, I don't know if you guys are going to see this on YouTube, but if you are watching on YouTube, make sure that you subscribe and click the like button and leave a comment. Normally we put our shows up on YouTube, and you guys out there, go to our YouTube channel, The Going Way Back Show, and subscribe.
There it is. Thanks, Todd Teezy. Speaking of 20-year anniversaries, there's a few more anniversaries for hip hop that we haven't mentioned or that's not mentioned. 22 years ago today, September 13th, the Notorious B.I.G. Ready to Die was released.
Oh, exactly. I have a question. There was a question actually in the chat room. What didn't you like about the movie?
What didn't I like?
Yeah. The Notorious movie or the
Notorious movie?
Yeah. My scenes that got cut.
Oh. No, the Notorious movie?
No, the Notorious movie.
The Notorious movie.
It was just Boosie. It was like after school special type. I don't know. It just was what?
Lifetime.
You know what? I didn't like the way they portrayed Pac. It was corny. It was just corny to me.
Because, I mean, in Pac's movie, they used the dude that they used in Notorious.
Yeah, but it was just corny. I can't explain it. You know, corny is corny.
Gotcha.
That's it. Another classic album that came out on this day in 1988, Ice-T's Power.
What?
Was released. That's right.
I love that picture.
Yeah.
Darlene.
It's tarnished for me now.
Shout out to Darlene.
Oh, why? Oh, yeah, I know why.
Yeah.
You want to speak on it?
You know what? I'm not even going to speak on
it. Not going to speak on it?
I'm not going to give nobody no shine that don't deserve it, but it's tarnished.
It's tarnished?
Yeah.
Bad?
Like you said, you know, corny is corny.
Corny is corny.
Corny is corny. Once you got corny, then you just corny.
Then why did you still wear the t-shirt? I washed it the other day.
I wear it to the gym to sweat in it.
It's a collector's item. You need to pass it over.
If you're going to do that, pass it over.
It's not even worth a hand-me-down.
Okay,
it's a classic album and it's a classic album cover.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I ain't going to take that away. Hip-hop, classic hip-hop's classic.
I mean, the front and then the back.
Front and back.
It was crazy. You never knew they were all carrying those things until you flipped over the back.
Did y'all notice on that album cover that she needed her eyebrows waxed?
We weren't looking at our eyebrows.
Oh, okay. I didn't think
right.
so.
It's cool. Before they push us out, you know, we got to do what we do. And that is a segment we like to call Who Said It? Now, those of you who haven't seen our show before, Who Said It? Tantizi, she says a classic line from a classic hip-hop song. And it's up for you, the audience, to guess who said it. And special incentive, we got Going Way Back Show t-shirts here, but we also want you to donate and get a signed Digital Underground t-shirt, either Humpty Dance or Sex Packets. And even if no one calls in, POTUS, I'm going to sign some. I'm going to get some signed and leave them for you to raffle off.
Definitely.
At any time. You know what I mean? You know, within the next 20, you can do it. I'll leave them so you can show them, and then we'll get, you know, whoever donates and gets the t-shirts, however you want to call it.
Now, are these actual album covers on these shirts?
Yes, the Sex Packets was our first album. That was the one that put us on the Mizap, and this cover, and then the Humpty Dance. This is our 12-inch. Our double platinum 12-inch cover. I think both of them went double platinum. Yeah, drop that drop that one more time. You know, everybody don't do that. I'm just saying.
I know.
You know, Grammy nominated.
Yeah, this is Grammy.
So on
know.
And so forth. So.
Seven times.
And I don't think OGP was throwing us out just yet.
No, you got a few minutes.
We can throw up that 10. I don't know if that means dropping.
We've been experiencing all kinds of hand signals.
I don't know if that means push-ups or what, but normally that means you got to get out. So let's do the first one. We'll run through them.
All right, the first.
Oh, that you can play with us.
Yeah, okay. Please try and guess.
All right, good luck. Help me with my problem. It was never much, just a trick to smell her scent and try to sneak a touch. Who said it?
Anybody? POTUS?
Could you recite it one more time?
Yeah.
Help me with my problem. It was never much a trick to smell her scent and try to sneak a touch. Who said it?
Oh my God, it's right there.
Come on, the number if you want to call in.
323-293-3375.
Make that donation to the GoFundMe page, Morris Media Studios. Is it MorrisMediaStudios.com on GoFundMe?
Yeah, it's GoFundMe.com/MorrisMediaStudios.
GoFundMe.com/MorrisMediaStudios.
To give a recent tally, we are up to $3,471.
So we got a couple while we've been here, huh?
Yeah, a couple bucks.
Nice.
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 It looked like we got a caller. Got to get the signal from OGP.
Anyone? Bueller? Bueller? Bueller?
Okay. Caller, what's your name? Where are you calling from? Oh, hold on. Caller, what's your name? Where are you calling from?
This is Shadell from Inglewood.
Hey. Do you know who said it?
I think it's a homie from the far side.
What's the name of the song?
Passing Me By.
We got a winner. Play it.
Yeah, he got it.
Turn your radio down.
Yeah, yeah.
I was on our job.
I already donated. I'm listening to you. Yeah.
Yeah. We can give you a t-shirt, though.
Yeah, we're going to get you a Going Way Back Show t-shirt. And if you want to make that that big donation and get a signed Digital Underground shirt, you can do that as well. But if not, OGP is going to take your information and your size.
If you don't mind.
And we'll get you a Going Way Back Show t-shirt sent right out to you, bro.
That's what's up. That's good looking.
Appreciate
it. Thanks for calling in and playing the game.
Hang on the line.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Tantizi.
Hang on the line. Tantizi got her own fan club.
Bro. That's right.
She sure do. That's why she had to get it right coming up here. She knew this the big time. See, these are my real fans. Fuck what y'all doing over there.
He's my real fans.
Yeah, this is where I'm
my fans are over at Morris Media.
This is what's gonna make or break me right now.
Y'all shut up. Y'all ready for the next one?
Yes.
Are we doing another one or you wanna wait?
Let's go to the next one.
All right. As the Jules jingle from the Hot Young and Single, Little Stunt, a 40 and a blunt. Wait, you're on the mic.
Turn your mic off, POTUS. POTUS.
She in there on the mic.
Turn
like
your mic's on, sweetie.
Everybody go have his address.
POTUS in there like, so what you got on?
Got the thong on, really?
Okay, let me start.
Oh, she in there like, so what you wearing? Yeah, I'm wearing it too.
All right. As the Jules jingle from the Hot Young and Single, Little Stunt, a 40 and a blunt, that all she really wants.
Okay. I got it. Brand Nubian.
Got it.
Yay.
What song?
Turn me up.
What song?
Come on. You know the song.
Say the lyrics one more time.
As the Jules jingle from the Hot Young and Single, Little Stunt, a 40 and a blunt, that's all she really wants.
You gotta name the song.
Is all she really wants. Is hanging a blunt. Is all she really wants. Play a little bit.
We don't do that here. That's not part of the game.
Oh, not Punk's Jump Up.
No. The other one.
Oh, hold on. I got this.
You looking online?
No, I'm not. It's
Look,
I'm giving it to her.
Oh. Uh-oh, somebody said it in the chat room, I think.
Forget it. I know. Oh, I can't think of the name of the song.
Call in OG Sleepy Lope. 323-293-3375.
Say one more time. Don't hit us up. We're going to move to the next one.
Do it.
Okay, hold on.
A 40 and a blunt is all she really wants.
Okay.
It's
As the Jules jingle from the Hot Young and Single, Little Stunt, a 40 and a blunt, that's all she really wants. Who said it?
Gosh.
She don't got
it. I know who said it, but I don't know the song.
You know the song.
Give it
too.
To her.
You want to.
Oh, God.
You should have called in.
I did Brand Nubian.
Yes. You had it. I was like, no, the other one.
Okay.
All right, we got to wrap, you guys.
Okay. We have two more songs.
Come on, hurry up. These are easy. POTUS going to get them. Go ahead.
He said, I will not. Okay, number three. I'm raging, ripping up the stage, and don't it sound amazing? Because every rhyme is made in. Who said it?
You got this, POTUS. I know you got this.
It's the POTUS challenge.
Come on now. Somebody I know you got this, POTUS.
Big A, I need you to step in. I need you to hear this. Tell us who said this rhyme. Just go.
No. Okay. Just stand over there. Okay. Listen to time.
Get out my shine, man. Don't step in my shine. Come on.
Listen to time.
All right. I'm raging, ripping up the stage, and don't it sound amazing, because every rhyme is made in.
Who said it, and what song it came from?
Don't sound amazing.
I'm raging, ripping up the stage, and don't it sound amazing, because every rhyme is made in.
Who said it?
Lady of Rage.
Lady of Rage? Oh. We give it to her one more time, and we're going to let you hear.
I'm raging, ripping up the stage, and don't it sound amazing? Because every rhyme is made in.
POTUS.
Who said it?
I want to say the Zoom, 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 Craig Mack.
Someone in the chat
room. They got to call in. I ain't trying to hear the chat room right now.
Call in 323-293-3375.
Is the phone ringing?
No.
All right, well, let's give it to him. We got one more, then we out of here.
Fighting for making teams.
You know what I mean?
That's what they said, too.
People in the chat room getting it. Y'all should be trying to call in and get these prizes.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I ain't hearing no chat. The chat room don't work with this game. This is the last one, and we out. Chat room, call up if you want to win.
323-293-3375. And the last one is, it's Friday night. I got a brand new kit on a fifth of heme. For me to get bent on, said it.
And none of y'all gonna get this.
Ain't nobody gonna get this. Did you hear that, POTUS?
No, she didn't hear
it. Say it again. Say it again.
Say it.
It's Friday night. I got a brand new kit on, a fifth of heme for me to get bent on. Who said it? Your mic's not on.
I don't know.
Now, one thing we had to do, because Tati tried to call me out a few weeks ago. Every who said it is a single, so you can't be like, oh, he never.
It's a single,
So everyone is a single from now on. It's been a hit. Now, POTUS.
It sound like we got a call.
Oh, we might have it. Who we got?
Well, let's talk.
Yeah, we're gonna keep it moving. Say it one more time. Do like this. You're sweating over here.
Oh, am I? Yeah, get that lip. Yeah.
Tell you, man, that hateful lady is watching.
What's up, man?
About to be the hateful nine in this bitch. Add me to the crew.
All right.
Hate.
It's Friday night. I got a brand new kit on, a fifth of heme for me to get bent on. Who said it?
Now, Fee, you know they only say heme in the Bay Area.
Oh, that's a clue.
That's a hell of a clue.
Yeah, that's a hell of a clue. Heme. I'm drinking that heme.
One more time.
It's Friday night. I got a brand new kit on, a fifth of heme for me to get bent on. Who said it?
Mac, Mom. I don't know.
So destructive.
He's a boy. Let him.
Anybody in the chat room got it? We'll give y'all.
Anybody in the
chat
room?
Y'all can't win, but if y'all know it.
Anybody in the chat room need to call in?
Back to the hotel. Selly Cell. Somebody said Selly Cell.
Somebody said Selly Cell. Somebody said what else?
Back to the hotel.
Ding, 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 ding.
Too deep.
Huh? In too deep. Back to the hotel.
But the other one, Selly Cell, wasn't right.
See, if you would have called in, you would have won the prize. Play it.
I hated that song.
Me too.
Me too. They play that shit out here.
Got a kit on and a theme so I can get bent.
We ain't taking no more calls.
We out.
Mine and Tontese. Well, shit, hang on.
What happened?
Well, please make a donation. So we can get some new floors and walls up in here.
He's from the Bay Area.
I guess they didn't hear it. We're on delay, so somebody called. But it's too late now. But I want to...
Sorry, caller. Thanks for calling.
Thank you, Mun and Tontese, and always for coming by and supporting our fundraiser today.
Always.
Hey. Really appreciate it.
I appreciate being here.
Starting to feel myself fading fast, so I better go give me a Red Bull. Yeah.
You need a 5-hour.
Hey, and incidentally, POTUS is responsible for me being here. She actually introduced me to Mun. Show because it was a bit much to handle on the boards at the time. She put us together. I was here to play the music, and great things had developed from it. So I appreciate you, POTUS. Thank you very much.
I appreciate all of you guys. And coming up, we
have. Wait. And I'd just like to say thank you for putting me in this seat because I didn't want to do it. And you did push me into doing it. And I've been doing it ever since.
See, and people think I'm me. Yeah. I just be making people. Just making people fulfill their dreams. That's all.
Right.
You see the potential.
Fulfill their potential and fulfill their destiny. Right. That's what POTUS do.
Right. That's what I does.
POTUS, that's what she does.
Thanks for having us. Real quick, Tontese, let them know.
What?
Oh, shit. Always.
TON_TEEZY on all social media, including Snapchat. Always.
Always in the air on Twitter. And you can catch me at I Am DJ Always on Instagram and every Friday on the Foxhole, Sirius Channel 96.
Yeah,
Foxhole.
You know it.
Afternoon We're going to take about a 30-minute break, and then we'll be back with Mad Marv's Comedy Lounge, and after that, In a Man's World.
At Money B69. You know it. Holla.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel, The Going Way Back Show.
Bye.